You found a place to belong here in this circle of friends. I'm Beth, and the table is a little more full today, so my heart is happy. Gwen and Glory and Missy, our silent member today is Missy, but you know, even when she's silent, she uses great sign language, and she makes us sound even, you know.
Even better.
Yeah, even better. So welcome to the table, my friends.
Thank you. And Beth, I can't even tell you, I'm so excited to get her here. Uh-huh. I think I've been trying for how long to get
it's
you
It's been
to
a
come?
Long time. Yes.
Yeah. So she was nervous.
Well, little microphone shy.
Okay, so that's what I was going to ask. What kept you from coming to the table?
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm not very outspoken. I don't feel like I'm well spoken. I don't know. Hmm. It's more nerves, I think, than anything.
Nerves,
do you know what I mean?
A little bit of fear.
A little bit of fear.
A little bit of Moses-itis.
There you go.
Oh. It's pretty awesome how God allows His Word to show us that there are others who feel exactly as we feel. You know, yesterday, as I joined you, I mentioned, I believe, at the end of our program that I am easily intimidated because of my lack of education. And yet, I read in the Word of God that Jesus chose those mm-hmm. common people. And I can so relate because it's not about the letters after my name, it's about the letters that I read straight from the heart of God. Miss Moses, thank you for joining us at the
so
table.
Cute.
I recently completed a Bible study with a group of lovely women. And one of the lessons that we were pointed to was, I believe it's in Exodus 3, where Moses, who was a prince, mm-hmm. you know, big dog mm-hmm. in the world mm-hmm. standards, suddenly kind of journeyed down the mountainside to a valley of being a shepherd. Mm-hmm. How many of us wake up one day and say, oh, I hope I get to be a shepherd today. I'd like to take care mm-hmm. of those sheep that are not very bright, and I'd like to smell like those sheep that are not really clean. No, I don't think that was part of his bucket list. Mm-hmm. However, it was while he was the shepherd mm-hmm. that God called him. And the lesson that I want to remind us all of again, and I've probably said it on the radio within the last couple of weeks, but it's a good reminder for each and every one of us, is that while Moses was doing what he was doing, mm-hmm. being the shepherd, that's when he saw the burning bush, and he had a choice right there. He could have run from it and said, what the world? Yeah. Avoid, ignore, run. He could have kept on in his busyness, taking care of his sheep, but the Word says he turned toward it. And then it says, and when God saw that he turned toward this thing that he didn't understand, that's when God came and spoke to him. Yeah. Now, Moses still had excuses after that, remember? And one of them was that he was not well-spoken. I can't do this, you know, I'm tongue-tied. But what a great lesson. What a great reminder from the story of the one that led the children of Israel out of Egypt, into the wilderness. You know, there was a little, the desert, we're a little scared there, and yet the promised land was waiting.
And you know, think about it, he spent years leading sheep through the wilderness,
right?
Knowing water supplies, safe places, all those kind of things, how to shelter, you know, wild animals, all of that kind of stuff, in preparation to lead a whole bunch of people, human sheep,
human sheep,
through the same scenario in the same wilderness. That is just amazing that at the moment of the burning bush, he was already being prepared for what God had for him.
Well, and I just read in the Word this morning, again, from 1 Corinthians verse 10, about Moses. So that's probably why it's fresh in my mind. It says, I don't want you to be unaware, brothers, that our fathers were all under a cloud and all passed through the sea and all were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea and all ate the same spiritual food and all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ. Mm-hmm. And I thought,
love
that. We are drinking from that same rock today. Mm-hmm. So why are we so fearful?
I don't know.
Because we live in a fallen world. That's why we're fearful.
But you know, I love that you bring Moses up because of what we talked about yesterday with friendship.
Mm.
And I'm sorry, I have to go to Exodus 33:11.
Okay.
It is one of my favorite verses in all of Scripture. I'll give you guys a minute to get there, but how about if I just go ahead and read it? Thus the Lord used to speak to Moses face to face as a man speaks to his friend. I love that. And then when Moses returned to camp, his servant Joshua, son of Nun, a young man, would not depart from the tent. I love that because that my heart for discipleship, like, is a young man observing another's walk with God. Mm-hmm. You know, and here you've got Joshua who sees Moses talk to God as a friend, and he doesn't want to leave that tent.
Right, right. It's funny, Gwen, I was going to underline something from Exodus 33, but it's already underlined, the words you just spoke. Yeah, it just jumps out at you how so much of the word, I write in my margins often, then and now. So applicable to life today. And yet so many people kind of are afraid of the Old Testament, don't want to read. I just had a woman tell me the other day, I have never read through the Bible. And I said, oh, I highly encourage it. Not just one time, because the first time it's kind of, okay. For me anyway, I kind of slogged through maybe the first several years. But now I read through and it's like revisiting an old friend and the reminders from yesterday and the truths of today. And oh, I have something so exciting to tell you. I know what Bible I'm going to be using for my adventure reading through the Bible next year. I've had a request from my son that I take the Bible that, remember, this is the son that I found his Bible on the giveaway pile a number of years ago. Well, my precious former boss for my son's graduation got him a Bible. And they didn't make it to graduation, so not very long ago, I was visiting with them, and they said, hey, we got this for Clay for graduation and never got it to him. Do you think he would like this? And I said, well, I will ask. I said, I'll tell you, honestly, several years ago, his Bible was on the giveaway pile, and he said he didn't really need it, and and he broke his mama's heart, but that's all right, because God is faithful even when mama's hearts are breaking. But fast forward to just several weeks ago, my son was home from college. I gave him the Bible that my former boss, a man with no letters after his name, an eighth grade education, and one of the wisest men I have ever met. I said, hey, Eli wondered if you wanted this Bible. They got it for you for graduation. And Clay said, yes. Aww. I said, really? And he said, yeah, Mom, I've been wanting this. And I said, well, I still have your old Bible. And he said, oh, okay. He said, don't you read through the Bible every year? Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, would you read through mine next year? Aww. And he said, I'd like you to write and have highlights. I'd like that from you. So kind of broke this mama's heart, awesome. And yet overfilled it with joy. And it didn't break it in a bad way. But it was a thank you, Lord. He's recognizing that your word is what he has to stand on. So where were we? I just gave it a little.
And he's wanting to see, he's wanting tangible evidence of his mama's walk with God.
Yeah.
Through the word.
I love that. Our conversation just filled my heart with joy. My heart was broken and God filled it, because he is in that place of wanting to stand on the truth of God's word. And it's not my faith.
Yeah.
It's his. And I will tell you, we talk about accountability.
Yeah.
Accountability partners pray for each other's kids. Yeah. So this isn't just the prayers of this mama. No, this is the prayers of the aspens that were planted around me. Awesome. The roots go so deep, and there have been prayer warriors for my precious son for so many years.
But Beth, as a counselor, can I just say, well done.
Well,
you have kept a relationship with your kid through intense conflict.
Okay, so let's rewind here. So when you were talking about accountability yesterday, that's what I was thinking about. Accountability taught me to continue to love when I don't agree. So those years of not loving my son's choices, of not loving the words that I was hearing come out of his mouth, but continuing to love him and to present truth from my perspective. And that's what I would always say. I hear you, but in all I have is my 50-whatever-year-old perspective. Sometimes I forget how old I am. And then other times I go, oh, I'm really that old. Anyway, from my perspective, this is what I know. So accountability not only grows us, it grows the relationships around us because it changes who we are at the core. Yeah. So, yes, back to Exodus 33 and Joshua, who saw this man of God, friend of God, talking to God and saying, I want that. Yeah. Moses continued to do what he was called to do, whether the people agreed, whether it made sense, whether he was fearful, whether he just continued to do what he was called to do. He didn't get it perfectly, right?
Right.
I mean, before God called him, we know he was a murderer. After God called him, well, he never got to move into the promised land. He got to see it, but he never got to move in because he let his emotions overtake, go ahead.
But I'm going to highlight something. Joshua followed after him.
Yep.
And Joshua's life was ridiculously awesome.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And at the end of Joshua's life, he's looking at his family saying profound things about how he's lived his life. Mm-hmm. And so he caught from Moses a powerful, powerful example that he modeled. And he modeled hard. So he even avoided the pitfalls that Moses had fallen into.
Right.
And I think that's why Joshua is one of my favorite characters in scripture. And my precious son chose that name for himself. It just makes me so proud. But, you know, it's one of those things, like, truly from start to finish, Joshua's life is just excellence. Mm-hmm. It's just excellence. Mm-hmm. He was one of the most brilliant military leaders of all time. Mm. I had a friend who was military down in Tennessee, and his dad was writing a book about Joshua's military expertise and just how amazing he was. And so of all time, that was his dad's premise of all time. Huh. Joshua was literally the best military strategist.
That's cool. I hadn't thought about it from that aspect, from that perspective, but we can learn so much from the life of Joshua, and then we can go to the book of Joshua and see those awesome words that he gives to his people. Choose this day whom you will serve, but as for me and my house,
we will serve the Lord.
Yes, ladies, we need to take a little break and we will be right back. Thank you for joining us at this table. You have found a place to belong.
Village Gift Barn in Berlin, Ohio carries one-of-a-kind finds just as unique as you. Our elegant shop has everything you need to dress up your home and your wardrobe. We're dedicated to offering new, exciting merchandise. As you explore our three amazing floors, that's over 20,000 square feet, you'll discover everything from home decor and furnishings to a beautifully diverse women's boutique. Are your walls blank? Is your furniture blah? Do you never have anything to wear? We've got you covered. Stop by and let our friendly, knowledgeable team help you create a look that's all your own. Village Gift Barn is located in the heart of Amish country at 4755 State Route 39 in Berlin, Ohio.
What would you say if I told you that your sexuality is linked to your spirituality? This is Dr. Julie Slattery with Authentic Intimacy. I'm excited to be at the Amish Country Theater on Saturday, February 22nd for an all-day women's conference. Single or married, whether you're 18 or 80, you're invited for a day of worship and teaching. We'll spend the day learning why sex is important to God and why it should be important to us. Head to AuthenticIntimacy.com/event. That's AuthenticIntimacy.com/event.
There's a big bang.
Welcome back to the table. This is Circle of Friends, and you found a place of belong. I'm sitting at the table. We've had this wonderful conversation during break, and we're going to try to recapture it and recreate it. So we'll see how that goes. But just talking about how Joshua, we left at break talking about Joshua's watching Moses and his walk with God, and how Joshua ends up walking out this exemplary, amazing life. And so, you know, we're kind of sitting at the table and we're all mamas here. And, you know, so Gloria, I'm going to let you talk, say what you just said on break, because it was amazing. And I don't know how to throw it to you. Anyway.
Well, I was just adding to what Beth talked about with her son. And I feel the way I want to leave this world, I want to leave for my daughter a picture of Christ. And I know that if she has Christ in her life, I'm going to try not to cry here, that it's, it's going to be okay. I mean, she can handle anything this world throws at her. So I think that's so important.
I think sometimes we work so hard to give our kids possessions.
Right.
And really, the grandma's doily and whatever, does that really matter? And some would say, yes, yes, those are wonderful memories. Well, they are wonderful memories, but this word is truth for today. And so if I can, by my relationship with the Lord, model how that relationship truly impacted and affected and shaped my life to my kids, yes, I'm with you, Glory. It's the best thing we can give them. And it's why Joshua said, choose this day. Who are you going to serve? But me, my house, it's right here. We're going to serve the Lord. That's what I want to hand down to my kids.
And I'm right with you guys. Like, if there is nothing else my kids catch from me, I want them to catch the love of the Word and the love for the Lord. I want them to follow hard after Him. I want them to get, I want them to understand what Christ did and how much He loved them. I want them to understand that He was purposeful and intentional, and He moves in our lives that way. The last week I recorded with Missy, I talked about how Lena just accepted Christ as her Savior. And, like, I can't even tell you what my mama heart did to just know that both of my kids have made professions to walk with Christ and to join God's team and stay for a lifetime. And Lena's coming to understand fully what that means, but her little heart, she looked at me and she goes, Mommy, there's a party. And I said, what do you mean there's a party? And she goes, in heaven, there's a party. Because everybody who comes to God's family has a party. And so we had to have a party too. So it was just fun. But I love how much she's catching. And I love Josh and just how much he's catching too, of just being in the Word. The other day I caught him with his Bible.
That's great. That's where the relationship starts, is in His Word. I mean, that's your relationship right there.
Do you remember, this will date me, Audio Adrenaline's song, Big House?
It's a big, big house.
And it was, it's a party song. And I think about that, you know, it's happening. They are celebrating. It's a party song. Recently, my son shared a song. He is music minded, and so he loves sharing the music he loves with me. Well, lately, for whatever reason, it seems like the bent his music tastes are taking have a lot of Christian inspired artists. So yeah, it's awesome. So the song he shared with me is called Ma's Joint, which is kind of a strange title, but it spoke to him because it speaks about a mother who is loving her mother who has Alzheimer's. So Clay journeyed through that when he was in elementary school. My mom died in 2014, so he had just turned 13 when she died. But he saw that, and this song spoke to him, and it talks about, why do we make memories when you won't remember them when you're 70? But he said in this song, it says, and I was talking to my father, and he said, there's a point in making memories because you'll remember them when you're heavenly. Now, is that scriptural? I don't know. But what happened in the next part of this song is that it's a trumpet solo, and it's a big house. And there is a party happening in this trumpet solo. And that's the memory that I want to hold on to in whatever place we are at, mm-hmm. whatever season, whatever circumstance. The circumstances may not look great, but it's not about today. Mm-hmm. There is such a celebration awaiting us. Mm-hmm. We can't even fathom what's going to happen when we get to heaven. And so we do what's right and what's good and what's honorable mm-hmm. Today, trusting God for all of the tomorrows. Yeah. That's what I want my kids to grasp. Mm-hmm. Okay, this circumstance isn't easy. This mm-hmm. is hard. We didn't want to be here. I've said to Clay since he was little, I remember I would drive him to school, and I remember saying to him as he would get out the door, okay, today you can't choose a lot of things about your day, but there's one thing you can choose, and that's your attitude. Mm-hmm. Choose well. Make it a great day. So he's heard that constantly, and I really believe that, as Christ followers, is the call in our life. Mm-hmm. Choose well each and every day. This day, mm-hmm. who are you going to serve? You have your Bible open.
A verse just popped into my mind. James 1, verses 2 through 4. Consider it all joy, my brethren, when you encounter various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces endurance. And let that endurance have its perfect result, so that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. Mm-hmm. That just popped into my mind when you were...
It's so true. And I have in my margin here, oftentimes when I read something, I'll turn to the Moody Bible Commentary. And in my margin, it says, wisdom is not primarily knowledge, but godly behavior in difficult circumstances. Mm-hmm. Boy, isn't that exactly what we're trying to pass along to our kids? Mm-hmm. Choose this day. Mm-hmm. It's not going to be easy. Right. However, God's word is truth. That's the truth that we want to build our family on, yeah. our friendships on, our faith mm-hmm. on, and all of forever, however we live out our lives here on this earth, but beyond, because this is just a blip here, guys.
And, and don't you think, too, I feel like everything in God's word has it, you can tie it in with today.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, there isn't anything that's happening today that hasn't already happened, right. and mm-hmm. God has wisdom in here for it.
Right. Well, because the heart of man doesn't change. Correct. Our culture changes, mm-hmm. our circumstances change. But like I said, I was reading in the Corinthians mm-hmm. this past week, and so often I just write, then and now.
Yeah.
Then exactly. and now. Right. You know, this was happening to the early church. Oh, and it's happening to us today. This word that we have so available, we can get it on our iPhones. We can, how many copies of the Bible do I have in my house?
Exactly.
I don't know.
Right.
Yeah. More than I realize.
Yeah.
And we take it for granted.
Yeah.
That makes me sad. Yeah. However, we're not going to go on that tangent today. Today we're going to come back to this is truth. Mm-hmm. This is truth that is the foundation of relationships that will last. Yeah. Without the foundation of this truth, your relationship would not have lasted.
I would agree with that.
I agree with that too.
There would be no Gwen.
We're
kind
of opposites, actually.
We are. Mm-hmm. A lot. Mm-hmm. I'm late. She's on time. She's a planner. I fly by the seat of my pants really well.
I do. Yeah, I'm a multitasker. I can do 20 things at once. Mm-hmm. It drives my husband nuts, but.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. She's amazing. She has tackled her entire kitchen. Like, she's amazing. Like, she astounds me sometimes. She's
That's
fierce.
Awesome. And yet she looks at you and said, I mean, you said mm-hmm. earlier, in your role as a professional counselor, mm-hmm. some people are intimidated and you, mm-hmm. maybe they feel like you'll steamroll right over them. However, Glory doesn't. She can stand up. She can fix her kitchen and then come and stand mm-hmm. up to her friend if her friend's...
And she can give me advice. Yeah. She's good at it.
Yeah. You know, and here's the thing. When we have those heart friends, mm-hmm. they help us see if we're telling ourselves a false narrative mm-hmm. or a lie that we're believing is truth. Yeah. Whatever story is in our head. That's why accountability is so key, because we build those relationships and then we remind each other, but wait, where's that coming from? Does that come from the Word of God? And that's why you're still friends a few years later. You said freshman in high school. So what was that, like 7, 8 years ago?
Well, we wish.
Yeah. Really, Beth? We're 40. Well, right. You're 41. But
Thanks for pointing that out.
Sorry. You're older.
One of my accountability partners just reminded me within the last week or so that we've been 20 years into this.
Yeah. 25?
Yeah.
I figure ish. 25.
Yeah.
Ish, with a couple year break. But
right.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I can't imagine doing life without accountability. And really, as I talk with young women and I hear some of the stuff they are going through, I just want to say, okay, so who's your accountability partner? Come on. Mm-hmm. You need someone to walk this walk with you and to remind you of truth when your mind is so distracted by other things. So I'm so thankful that you have each other for that. But again, I think without the Word as your foundation, we wouldn't be sitting at this table today.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, and Beth, like before you walked in, we had talked about just how, I don't even know when it was, but it had to have been while I was in Tennessee. But the summer that I was home and fundraising, she and I got together and we did Romans. And we started in Romans 1 and we worked our way through, I don't even know how many chapters.
I'm not even but, sure.
I mean, we just chewed it, and I had never studied Romans before. So, I mean, it literally was the two of us just sitting down, asking text of it, and me just using of what I had.
And asking questions.
Right, and asking questions and looking up things as best we could. I mean, I don't know that up to that point I had even really been trained in Bible study technique or anything. You know, so we just kind of jumped in and started chewing it up.
Mm-hmm. Allowed the Word to guide.
Yeah.
I love it. You allowed the book of Romans to guide you in your relationship, but also in your knowledge and understanding of what the Word is saying to us then and now. Mm-hmm. And now. Yeah. So, oh boy, so many passages come to mind from that book of Romans, but we're at the end of our time together today. So, ladies, I'll meet you at the table tomorrow. Going to jump into the book of Romans and talk about how walking through the truth of God's Word can just grow and strengthen you, not only at your very core, but in your relationships too. We are so thankful that you joined us at the table today. You have found a place to belong here in the circle of friends. This program was brought to you through the generous support of donors and listeners like you. To contact Circle of Friends Ministries, you can write to P.O. Box 345, Berlin, Ohio, 44610, or find us on Facebook at circleoffriends.fm. Program archives can be found at thelight959.com.